paper. It hasn't been that long. There you go. There we go. Okay. That's more of the reaction I was thinking. There we go. Alright, I'll untangle you. There we go. There we go.
She been good?
She's been great. Luckily, she's pretty easy potty training wise inside, because she goes to pretty much right near the water bowl to go pee, and then she goes behind it to go potty, so to go number two. So those times I just take her outside and she goes out with the pack. So she's been really good about that. The only hard thing is definitely trying to take her out for a walk like everybody else, because I don't know if she's just not used to being outside, but she's just really, really hesitant, and I feel like she's not even able to relax enough to go potty when she's outside, because there's so much going on, or she's so scared or unsure or something. And that's usually why, when, as soon as she comes back inside, she goes to go potty, and then I just let her out into the yard, which at least she would feel safe doing it there. So it's some pros and cons for sure.
Yeah, walk around there, but she has gone.
That's good.
Yeah.
She might just be more used to your neighborhood then.
It's a lot quieter when we have a few cars going around, like around here.
Yeah. So right now we're just kind of building a positive association with the placement mat for the recall, and then just been practicing just normal recall while out and about, and just trying to get her used to the environment a little bit more. Good girl. Very good. As far as like expectations for being down, you can just wait for her to get down and then give her that attention. And she's, as you can kind of see here, she's getting better with it. She's probably going to have to rehabilitate herself with you guys.
Oh wow, look at that pup.
Kind of like a, what are they called, the wolfhounds? What do you think, huh? She's definitely interested. Hi. What? It's okay. Come on. Good girl. There we go. Good. We're gonna try to do right now is just kind of go and let her free roam a little bit, and then just work on some recall with you guys. A I'll give you a couple treats to give to her. Perfect. There you go. And the main, as I know, the main goal here is to kind of do it sparingly. We really want her to get distracted and kind of get used to and absorb the environment. And then whenever she's not like completely into something, then it'd be a good idea to offer, say her name and then offer a treat coming in. You can even add to come on to your left side too if you want to. So this is good because she's kind of concentrating on them. There we go. Good. Good girl. And then if she ever just checks in normally too is when I'll also kind of give her a treat as well. That's more of like the opposite kind of training, whereas you just kind of feel naturally rewarded to check in periodically. Good girl. We're gonna have to look around. I think I have a smaller red coat for her because it's getting so cold out, and I think Mars needs that too. But I'll let you guys know. I kind of tried to make this one fit just because I felt so bad for her. She was looking really cold or really nervous. It was hard to tell which, and figured it might even be both because it is so cold out here. So wanted to at least try to get her something on. Yeah. You can also tell that she's still kind of in the early stages of potty training, or is nervous because of the fact that she went inside the pet store, you know, just randomly. Even though we tried to walk outside and she at least peed outside. But sometimes, especially in those situations where it just fits her, you know, you just don't have enough time to take her right back out. So the next time when she you get her attention, go ahead and either show her or bring down the treat so that way she sees and comes to you instead. She's just too used to coming to me right now. I'll also move a little bit this way away from you too to help out.
Izzie.
Izzie, come. Good girl. Now you try.
Izzie, come.
There we go. So just getting down a little bit lower to her eye level to get her attention, and then just adding a little bit more encouragement works. There we go. Much better. There we go. Good. Alright, now we'll just kind of follow you around for a little bit. Hopefully she'll just naturally follow and just have a treat ready in case she does catch up to us. If not, we'll just wait here. She does. Again, give her another recall chance.
Izzie, come.
Perfect. Girl. Good girl. So right now, just using the leash as a boundary, and then just rewarding her for when she does the right thing. Trying not to, just pull her wherever. So that way she, understands the leash pressure, and then also learns to make the right decisions on her own accord. Very good. Good girl. Yeah. I break these in half too, so if you need more, just let me know. She's burning off a lot of calories too.
Playing
too. She and Duke are pretty much best friends. She got the zoomies inside earlier. That was fun. Good girl. There we go. Good girl. And you can use a standard leash like this too. You just have to be more mindful of what she's interested in and then close the gap that way by following her. Because sometimes she just ends up pulling because she's just out of leash, like the bush there is interesting and you're just like a foot off. So I want less pressure, but when there is pressure, more important pressure, if that makes any sense. And that kind of helps to reaffirm the training and her to not just, get used to the pressure again and pulling and it not meaning anything. So that's why we're trying to do it less often, but then each time it's just more impactful. Okay, let's walk back this way. Oh, good girl. Very good. Good. So I'm just calming her down a little bit when she seems like she wants to jump like that. And I just want her to be nice and calm. Very good. Especially at first, you do like high repetitions with treats, and then later on, as she gets better about following, that's when I just start weaning off a little bit more, treating her every other time where she redirects her focus, or every third to fifth time, and after that every fifth to tenth time. So that way, you're still rewarding her, but you can also wean off of it so she's not just doing it the treats every time, but she's doing it to pay attention to you. Mm-hmm. Good girl. Yeah. Very good. Perfect.
No treat. Just gonna pet you.
could just ask her to come. Most of it you can kind of tell is just body movement, really. Good girl. I think I just asked her to wait or calm down just with a finger. You can also put any kind of name or command to it, so long as you're consistent, and she'll pick it up pretty quickly. This is only 2 weeks anyway, so try to make it so pretty easy to transfer her over without, you know, very strict or certain commands. More so like just the routine of behaviors we want her to get used to. Good girl. Like, we want her to be excited, so not jump for the tree. And we want her to be excited to catch up and follow us too. Good. There you go. Stay out of the water, it might be pretty cold. Good girl. Yes, good. Oh, like I said, one of those times when just using the leash as a boundary and having that expectation for her to either come with you. You can always apply light pressure, but you don't want to be like dragging her all the time. It's easier with smaller dogs, but you want to try to apply this principle so that way it works with bigger dogs too, or if, you know, children need to walk her or anything. You're just more so, she's following more with focus than with force is the main thing. It's also why I'm not too interruptive of her out here, because I kind of really want her to try to get used to seeing as many things, and then also being able to redirect through those distractions too. So it's good when you have time for training that, you know, you really take into account what she needs and then work off of it from there. She found some peaks across last time. Central Park, man.
She can find anything.
There's
like another
protector
in the backyard.
Good girl. There you go. Perfect. Very good. There you go.
We're coming with you.
Good girl. Good wait. Yes. Good job. No. Good thing is too, she's stopping herself every now and then from jumping, so she's aware. She's got to get used to being excited and just doing it, you know, off of reaction or, you know. So I'll let you guys go on two opposite ends here, and I'll go in between, and we'll have her kind of ping pong between you two. It's about a 26 foot long leash, so we have some distance. But I'm gonna make it. That should be pretty good. Yeah. Yeah, this should be fine. All right. Hi. Perfect. There you go. Jacket's a little too long. Good girl. Very good. Very good. It's like kind of sliding down. I tried to tuck it in, but. Okay. Here, I'll give us some more, and then we'll. What we'll do is we'll keep kind of relocating. We'll do a couple more rounds of practice before we call it in, just because it's so cold.
It is so cold. I see people just walking around half the time.
Good girl. And then I'll just get in between you two again. Here we go. Good girl. Good girl. Making your rounds now. There you go. And what we'll do this time is I'll have you both go around the bathroom building there and then call her when you're out of line of sight too, which is good practice. Airplane. And you might have to keep calling her too, kind of like a radar. There you go.
Izzie, come.
There you go. Good. And that little bit of an exercise is good because it kind of makes her focus and concentrate more on finding you and that sound, which for a recall just helps to further develop that. It's really good in case you're further away or you're in like thick woods or something like that. Yeah. Yep. You'd probably be able to hide behind that tree, I think. You know, give that a shot. Very good. So you kind of see how she has to kind of search for it, which is good. Good girl. And that's a good easy exercise to do at home too. Like between floors or between different rooms, things like that, playing hide and seek. Good girl. Good girl. Perfect. Very good.
Good job.
Good girl. Very good.
Good girl.
So that's a good distraction there if you want to try to call her while that's going on. Good, there you go. Very good. This way. Very good. Good girl. Now we'll move a little bit closer towards the traffic and all the cars. And we'll do a couple more rounds and then we'll probably call it there. Oh. Got Miss Friendly over here. Oh. Good girl. Doesn't respond. It's good to pay attention to why, like if she's still in the middle of sniffing.
Yep.
There you go. Good girl. Perfect. Aww. Good girl. Good girl.
What's that?
Aww. Might just take it off of her. It's gonna trip her up. You wanna hold it?
Izzie. Izzie, come. No, she's listening. Izzie, come.
So interested in seeing the gentleman there, I guess.
Very interesting fellow.
Good girl. There we go.
Perfect. Good girl.
She loves her treats, that's for sure. It's just really important that she executes the command first, either with the visual cues or something, and then she gets the treat. usually you'll steer clear of problems that way. A lot of times people will get into a bad habit of presenting a treat to kind of bait and lure, and then what that teaches the pup sometimes to accidentally do is to not, you know, listen unless they see the treat. So that's why it's really important that, you know, you either tuck it in or hide it or whatnot, or then have her executed and then you can see too bad for it. Yeah. So now we're gonna be near traffic. It's gonna lock the leash to like a normal room. You can kind of see because I don't want her to kind of go around and explore, and I don't want her to be constantly pulling. You just have to follow her a bit more. Good girl. I have to be careful because the vest is now loose because it doesn't have the jacket underneath it as well. Might just switch it back to her collar. Good girl, hold on.
Almost.
There it is, thank you.
I know, now you're all tangled up though. There you go.
Whoa, man, so many big dogs out today. Hi, how you doing? Very good. Very good. Luckily, the EMT and fire station are both nearby. The EMT station's right there, and the fire station's down there. So you can get her some practice being around the big vehicles when they're not making sound, too, and getting used to people in uniform. Good girl. Good girl. How you doing? Wait. Good girl. Wait. Almost. Hi. One of those things, if you can get her to kind of sit and focus on you a little bit more preemptively than that, she'll be a little bit more inclined to listen than to kind of wait, and then you can kind of engage with the guest to see if they want to say hi or whatnot, and then release her. We did it a couple times at the pet store video, which was really good. Very good, very good. Good girl. it's gonna take some time for her to slow down and adjust her pace. If you're able to keep her focused on you, it's a little bit easier to treat. But she naturally walks a lot faster than you do. Good girl. Very good. There we go. Good girl. Taking a pup to the bus station too before. I'll probably have to do the same with Duke because he's afraid of the bigger vehicles and sound when he barks at him, so just getting used to it. Just checking out, huh? So cute. So the main thing is like when she starts hard pulling like that, to make sure that you take the time to stop instead of letting her kind of continue to make progress while doing that. Good girl. Yes. So especially for walks in the beginning, it might take some time. I always recommend if you only have like half an hour to go out 10 minutes and then save 20 minutes for your walk back. So that way you're not rushed or running late or anything. Because for us, usually the walk is getting from A to B, whereas for dogs, the walk is everything in between A to B. Good girl, this way, yes. She's doing well though. Just been, like I said, just using the leash as a boundary. Let her kind of get used to everything. Good girl. Very good. Stopping and waiting at crosswalks. We're actually gonna go this way. Where'd you guys park?
Over there.
Right beside the park.
Okay, yeah, we'll head back that way then. Perfect, good girl. You might not be able to show it tomorrow's video because of the snow, but when the weather gets a little bit better, I'll kind of show you some of the structured drills in the video that we've been doing to help out with her starting and stopping and keeping focused and things like that. Okay. Go ahead and hang a right. There we go. That way I can let her free a little bit again. Good girl. You see, that's how her natural pace is. So in comparison to ours, it's much, much of a gap there. Good girl. You guys have any questions or anything so far? Oh, and she hasn't been extra barky or anything at home either. No one else has knocked on the door or anything, so. The only time I think she's ever barked was when she was playing with Duke and they're all really hyped up.
Oh, yeah, she does that.
Yeah, that was pretty much it. So you're still okay on that behavior-wise. Good girl, very good. I'll let you guys say goodbye. I'll let her get home and get warmed up and get some water. Good girl.
That's how we get her to like kind of stay in speed with us.
That's good. Perfect.
Is that what that's for?
Mm-hmm. Like I said, the more that you have her focused on you anyways while you're walking, the less that you have to do it. But just starting and stopping and then light pressure on the lead But mostly, been using just like cones and then just stopping and starting, trying to lose her a little bit.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah, at least the dog I had before, we'd walk and then I would change direction really quick.
Yeah. It's just a, it just kind of forces her pretty much to pay attention to you and what you're doing and where you're going. You kind of just make a fun.